Wonderful greetings today. My name is Dwayne Henneman, and I'm a senior life agent specializing in irrevocable senior trusts, namely irrevocable funeral trusts, speaking to you from Denver, Colorado. I want to bring to your attention a special senior law update, a new law that most seniors, most elder law attorneys, and most financial planners are not even aware of yet. A new law that protects your final expense money and more from nursing homes, Medicaid, and any other creditors. So, without immediate action, the money to fund those final expenses and so on may not be there when you need it, and here's why. The Deficit Reduction Act that was signed into a law by President George Bush that became a law in February 2006 really has changed the seniors' eligibility for health care and nursing home assistance for the long-term future. Most seniors who require health care, and up to 50% of us will require health care and nursing home assistance, can rely on government assistance to fund their expenses. The program, however, is based on need, and if you have more than a few thousand dollars, you'll have to spend down your assets first before becoming eligible for such assistance. Unfortunately, that means the money that you've set aside to pay for your funeral expenses and so on can be lost if it's not handled correctly. And what's more, you can't beat the system by transferring or gifting any of your money, as any transfers of funds or property made by you within 5 years, 60 months of applying for assistance, this being true in Colorado and in any other state as far as that's concerned. But there is a solution, however, a way to guarantee that the money that you want to set aside for final expenses and more will be there when it's needed. Money that can never be attached by nursing homes or Medicaid or the government, lawyers or any other creditor. And that solution is setting up a irrevocable funeral trust. But before we talk about that, let's just talk about for a moment the main concerns of seniors today. And some of the main concerns are the death of a loved one, obviously, outliving your money, nursing home confinement in general, failing health and losing one's independence, and the high cost of final expenses. So let's face it. No one wants to think about issues such as death. No one wants to think about that. But somewhere, someplace along the way, someone will have to make those decisions. What kind of funeral? Who's going to pay for it? Who will make those decisions? It becomes a real burden. So at some future date, someone will be responsible for making your final funeral arrangements and paying for them. Who will it be? How will they pay for your funeral? Unfortunately, today, funeral expenses are just skyrocketing like everything else. 10 years ago, an average funeral nationwide was about $4,000. Today, average funeral across the country is running from $8,000 to $10,000. So what's going to be in 5 and 10 years in the future from today? And you know what? If you spend down your life savings down to the $2,000 to become eligible for Medicaid and nursing home assistance, then you have no funds remaining to pay for your final expenses. So it's just time that a person has to make some decisions that will affect their life positively. And if you are confined to a nursing home, unfortunately, the nursing home confinement costs range anywhere from $3,000 to $8,000. And actually, the average is about $6,000 in most nursing homes today. And unfortunately, like we said, 50% of us are going to enter a nursing home whether we like it or not. And that's unfortunate, but it's just the facts. And 70% of people that enter that nursing home will be absolutely out of money if they're on private pay, paying $6,000 a month within 33 weeks or about 8 months. And that's pretty frightening. And further on that point, 7 out of 10 couples, married couples, if you will have one or the other spouse within a nursing home. So it is a major, major situation. So they're to qualify for Medicaid and help in paying for the nursing home, which the majority of us are going to have happen, you've got to do the old spend down that some of us are familiar with. And when you get your money spent down to a certain level, then you can qualify for Medicaid. So that brings up the importance and the introduction of the irrevocable funeral trust that was created by the Deficit Reduction Act. And it, frankly, it's a blessing and a curse to seniors today. The blessing is the seniors can legally set aside $12,500 into this new irrevocable trust, and whatever they need to pay for their final expenses can be drawn out of that $12,500, and the remaining money that's left over then would go to their beneficiaries. But this creates a legal safe haven from Medicaid, nursing homes, attorneys, and other creditors. That's the blessing part, that you can set that aside today. The curse is the new look-back rule. It is now 60 months instead of the original 36 months, meaning that seniors can't gift away or transfer funds or property without being subject to potential penalties when applying for assistance. And that is just the way it is today. But now that you have the information and the knowledge and the solution, and you are not in a crisis situation, doesn't it just make sense to take advantage of the things that we've just discussed? If you're 65 years and older and you want to learn more about how to take advantage of these issues without any cost or obligation to you whatsoever, you can receive information on this new lawful way to reduce your assets while still being eligible for nursing home assistance and more. So why wait until it's too late? Call me today. Call Duane Henneman here in Denver at 800-220-0468. 800-220-0468. And oh, by the way, life insurance agents and elder law attorneys, financial planners also need to give me a call to be able to best serve your senior clients. And let me just close with this. You know what? No one knows the future, so why not plan for the worst and hope for the best? Thanks for listening, and we look forward to talking to you soon.